Yo, what's going on YouTube, and welcome back to another video. Now today, as you may have already guessed by what you see in front of you, I'm going to be unboxing the brand new Nintendo 3DS, which comes out this Friday, February the 13th. Now, just before I kick this video off, I want to give a massive shout out to Nintendo for very kindly hooking me up with this so I can show you guys what it has to offer. And on top of that, they also very kindly sent me a couple of amiibos, which will work in conjunction with the new 3DS's NFC capability starting tomorrow, 10th of February, and also this sweet Luigi faceplate. But I've kept you waiting long enough, so let's get this open. Now there are two versions of the new Nintendo 3DS. This one, which is the smaller of the two, and comes with interchangeable faceplates for both the front and the back, or top and bottom, however you want to see it, and then you have the XL, which doesn't come with the option for interchangeable faceplates, but has the added bonus of a much bigger screen. Now I'm going to be putting out a more in-depth video for you guys later this week to give you a proper overview of all the new features, but for the time being, here's what you need to know. First up, one of the new and probably most exciting additions for me is the C-Stick. I've always wanted this on my 3DS, and clearly Nintendo realised this when they released the CirclePad Pro for the previous 3DS models, but the main problem with that is it did make things a little bulky, especially for a handheld console. So, having this fully integrated means you now have better camera control in-game. This is going to be especially great in Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate, where if you don't have a C-Stick or a CirclePad Pro, you need to rely on a touchscreen D-pad to move your camera around. Then on top of that, as mentioned, the new 3DS also includes NFC support, which is designed to work with amiibos. The update for this drops tomorrow, February 10th, and when it goes live, you'll have the same functionality you do on your Wii U, where you can scan your amiibos into Super Smash Bros. 3DS or other games, but now instead, you can simply touch your amiibo on the bottom touchscreen, and you're ready to go. In addition to that, the top screen on both the regular and XL versions has improved face tracking 3D. See, the problem with the older model was that if you angled your 3DS a little too far to the left, or to the right, or even up and down, you'd lose the optimal viewing angle for 3D. But with the new screens, that's no longer the case. You can move it around and tilt it much further than you were able to before, and you can still maintain that 3D viewing angle. And as if that's not enough, on top of all of that, the new 3DS also has more processing power, which means your system and games will load faster, and some existing games will even play better. Plus, in the future, there will be certain games that will only play on these newer systems. So, in a nutshell, that is pretty much everything you need to know. But just before I go, here's how easy it is to swap faceplates. The top one simply slides out, and then you can click a new one back in place. The bottom one does have a couple of screws, and I'll demonstrate that in the next video, because that's also where the battery and the SD card slot are located. But for the time being, you can tweak the look of your 3DS as easy as that. Now, make sure you keep it locked to the channel later this week to catch a more in-depth look at the new system, and I'll show off the newly added amiibo functionality. But for now, hopefully you enjoyed this video, and if you did, be sure to leave a like and click that thumbs up button, and make sure you subscribe to be part of the RX Gaming Nation so you don't miss a single video. I want to give another massive shout out to Nintendo for kindly sending this my way, and thanks again for watching. Take it easy, catch you next time, peace out.